Well, that was a real good night's sleep.
It's our tent for the night.
No, I'm just kidding with you.
Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm glad you returned. If you're new to the channel, my name is Chris, and I'm glad you came along for the adventure today. As you can see, we're back from Puerto Rico. It's sunny, but it's not nearly as warm as it was there. My wife and I are currently camping at French Creek State Park, which is located in Elverson, Pennsylvania. You know, we're just kind of hanging out here for the weekend, see what this place has to offer, and take you along and check it out. So, you know, we're going to go do a quick campground tour, show you around there, and then head over to the Hopewell Furnace. You know, it's located roughly, I want to say, within probably about 5 minutes from the campground. You know, we're going to show you around over there and see what we can see. So, you know, just remember before you forget, make sure you comment, like, subscribe. It'll really help out the channel, and let's get this adventure started.
All right. Ready, kid?
Montar dikejot maju mundur sedulur beparengan sepedaan oleh keringat ben seger kuarasa montar sarengan ro rencange.
So here is the B loop, which is closed this year. I believe they're going to start doing some renovations here. I know last year they had redone A loop, and I believe this year, because it says B loop is closed this season, it looks like B loop is the year for improvements. Not a bad loop.
It's our first time here at French Creek State Park, but it looks like B loop is actually a pretty nice loop. If you guys have been here, leave some comments. Tell me which loop you like the best. And out of which loop you like the best, tell me what's your favorite campsites? What's your favorite number, site number? That concludes the B loop tour. We're going to move over to C loop. Looks like we got some yurts up ahead. Like this one's open, and we got some campers. I'll tell you, this is actually the earliest we've ever gone out camping before. Usually we start right around Easter weekend, but this year we were itching and we had to get out.
I wonder if they are like renovating a loop each year. Because B loop's closed this year. And A loop was closed last year. Here, I think it's pretty neat is each loop has its own camp post. So if you need something, just go to your camp post and your loop.
Enjoyed the quick campground tour that we gave you there. Before we head on over to the furnace, let me tell you a little bit about it. Hopewell Furnace is located in Elverson, Pennsylvania, about a half hour southeast of Reading, Pennsylvania. Hopewell Furnace is an early American landscape of industrial operations that operated from 1771 to 1883. Hopewell and other iron plantations laid the transformation of the United States into an industrial giant for the time. The park's 848 acres has historical structures such as a general store, blacksmith shop, community houses, school, stable, casting houses, furnaces, and much more. Let's go explore this historical site.
definitely been an adventurous morning for us, to say the least. It's currently like, I think 5:30 in the morning. It's very windy, very windy. It's rocking the camper back and forth and woke us up. Fortunately, we found out that we do not have water. So I just went outside and our hose is completely frozen. I think I looked on AccuWeather and the real field temperature right now is currently 14 degrees. So, yeah, that's our current situation. I think I'm going to head back to sleep and we'll deal with it later.
This is an interesting start to the morning.
Well, that concludes our trip to French Creek State Park. I hope you guys enjoyed it. You know, even though we had a couple hiccups this weekend, I have to say, you know, I think all in all, it worked out pretty well. You know, it could have been a lot worse. We were surrounded by a lot of people who were intense, and I can't imagine what they went through last night. Even our poor neighbor, when he went to go hook up this morning to dump his tanks before leaving, he blew a sewer hose. It more so kind of exploded. I don't know if it was due to the cold. But when he pulled his valve, it exploded everywhere. You know, we went over and asked if we needed any help. And I have to say, the guy took it like a trooper. You know, he had a smile on his face and said, "Nope, I think we're good." And crap happens. So, you know, I definitely got to give it to the guy. I don't know if I would have handled it that well. So, in regards to our frozen pipes, in full disclosure, there were signs posted everywhere, all over this thing, saying to make sure you turn it off if there are going to be overly cold temperatures. I want to say probably 3, maybe 4 signs and stickers, and I just wasn't paying attention and didn't see it. You know, plus I didn't think it was going to get as cold as it did last night. So, you know, it definitely could have been worse. It all worked out in the end for us. So, you know, the hose thawed out enough this morning while we were having our coffee that I was able to get that disconnected, used the crescent wrench so I could get it disconnected from the actual water source. I didn't want to just leave it like that. You know, luckily while we were out packing up, DCNR drove by and I let the ranger know that, you know, what had happened and, you know, apologized to him and, you know, see what we could do. But, really he just kind of laughed at me and said that he was in exactly the same situation this morning. So at least we weren't the only ones. Definitely a learning curve. You know, we've never gone camping when it's been this cold out before, but, you know, you live to learn. So we definitely learned that lesson. But yeah. So anyway, now that that's all taken care of, I did want to add a couple notes, you know, some fun facts that I thought were worth mentioning. You know, the campground is a very, very big campground. It has a lot to do. You know, luckily we have the electric bike, so it's a little easier to get around, even though this weekend it was a little colder. So we did do some driving. You know, but the campground has, you know, your typical has playgrounds, horseshoe pits, amphitheater, picnic tables, etc. You know, it does have a very large swimming pool. One thing that I would like to mention, I did hear from some of the locals there that were there that, you know, the pool gets fairly crowded in the summertime. I guess that has to do with people coming, you know, from the surrounding cities. They do offer day passes there that they can purchase. You know, and looking at the area, it has a huge parking lot. So I would say that that probably supports their claims. Another good thing is, you know, they have 2 lakes that are there. They have Hopewell Lake, which is actually right beside the swimming pool. So it's actually, you know, if you get to go in the pool and it's not too crowded, it's a beautiful scenery. You know, they do have boats that you can rent there. And also they have another lake that is probably, maybe 2 minutes away from that lake. That's called Scott Run Lake. And it looked like that one gets probably a little less crowded. You know, not really a whole lot of parking there, but it's a nice area to go take a walk, hiking. There are so many hiking trails that you can hike, bike, you know, go for a run on if that's your thing.
you know, it's there's so much activities here to do. You know, you're not going to run out of things, that's for sure. So one thing that I definitely thought was worth mentioning, since there is a lot of bike riding that's around, you know, I've never seen this anywhere that we've gone, at least, but right by the ranger station, they actually have a bicycle fixing station, which is pretty neat. You can put your, I'll put a little picture up here, but you could take your bicycle and put it up, and you can kind of stick it in like these little, your tires and these arms, and they have all the tools that you could possibly need to be able to fix your bike if you have anything go wrong. You know, I thought that was pretty neat. You know, a lot of times when you're biking, you certainly don't want to carry all that extra stuff in case something does go wrong. You know, I guess part of the downside of that would be you actually have to get to that location to be able to fix it. But you know, it is definitely a nice service that they have there, that you can, you know, fix your bike if you run into any troubles. All right. Well, anyway, it's time to get out of here. We're all packed up now. All we have to do is just, get on out of here. So I'm going to put the slides in, go get in the truck and head on home. It's about an hour drive home. And, you know, just remember, comment, like, subscribe. It definitely helps the channel out, especially since we're getting started. Yeah. You know, we hope that you continue to follow along, and we'll see you on the next adventure.